Hello everyone, I am Raj Kurav, studying in second year BAMS in Dr. G.D. Pore Foundation, YMT Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital. In this video, we are going to learn about Purish Pariksha or stool examination according to Ayurvedic and modern aspects. I have made this video under the guidance of Dr. Zaikin Imam. She is the Director of Research and PG Coordinator and also the Associate Professor of the Rog Nidan Department in YMT Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital. First, we will discuss the Ayurvedic Purish Pariksha. Before we see the examination method, first let us discuss the concept of Sama and Niram Purish. Sama Purish is the Purish which has the presence of Ama in it. The symptoms of Sama Purish are Sansrushtam Mebhir Doshay Stunyastamapsva Vasidati Purisham Prusham Durgandhim Vichinnam Chama Sangakam. It means Sama Purish combines with doshas, dhatus and other malas. It sinks in water. There is increase in quantity and frequency of mala vega. There is a change in color and consistency. Little quantity of stool comes out often with difficulty. There is discomfort in the Purish avayav and heaviness and pain in the abdomen. Now, let us discuss about Niram Purish Lakshan. Niram Purish is the Purish which is free from Ama. The shloka is Etan Nevatu Lingani Viparitani Yasyatu Laghavam Chamanushasya Tasya Pakvam Vinirdishet. It means that there is no amalgamation with other doshas, dhatus, and malas. The mala is of normal quantity, frequency, color, and there is a feeling of lightness. Now we will see the Jala Nimajjan Purish Parikshan given by Acharya Charak. The shloka is Majjatyama Gurutvatpit Pakvatutlavate Jale Vina Atidrava Sanghata Shaitya Shleshma Pradushanat. This test is done by dropping a small sample of stool in a container which contains water. If the mala is Sama, it sinks in the water. If it is Nirama, it floats on the water. However, this test should not be done if the stools are too liquid or too solid or mixed with kapha, as watery stools may float even in the presence of Ama and those mixed with kapha may sink even in the absence of Ama. These are the lakshan of malas in different diseases. In Jalodhar, the mala is Shita, Uti Gandha and Mahata. In Kshaya, it is of Shama Varna. In Amayukta Vyadhi, it is of Pita Varna. In Vataj Grahani, it is Shushka, Tanu and Fenavan. In Pittaj Grahani, it is Neela, Pita, Drava. In Kafaj Grahani, it is Bhinna, Ama and Guru. In Vataj Atisar, it is Aruna, Penila, Ruksha, Alpa. In Pittaj Atisar, it is Pita, Neela, Lohita Varna. In Kafaj Atisar, it is Shukla, Sandra, Visra and Shita. Now let's move to the modern stool analysis. It consists of collection of stool sample from the patient and its examination. Collection of stool sample. The early morning sample of stool is collected in a sterile universal container. Below is the picture of the universal container which is used for stool collection. Now let's discuss the examination of stool. It is done as physical examination, chemical examination and microscopic examination. First, we will see the physical examination or gross examination of stools. It consists of observation of appearance, color, smell, pH and visible parasite in the stools. Consistency. The normal stools are well formed. The following table shows the abnormal consistency and its possible reasons. It is pale, bulky and frothy in case of stetoria or poor fat absorption, hard in case of constipation, flattened and ribbon-like in case of obstruction of lumen of bowel, semi-solid in case of mild diarrhea or after taking laxatives, watery in case of bacterial infection, rice water-like in case of cholera. These are the types of stool according to the Bristol stool chart. There are 7 types which are given in the table. color of stool. The normal color of stool is light yellow to dark brown. The table below shows the abnormal color of stool. It can be black in case of bleeding in upper GI tract. It can be bright red if there is bleeding in lower level of GI tract, for example bleeding piles. It can be fresh blood and mucus in case of amoebic dysentery. It can be clay colored in case of post-hepatic jaundice or obstruction of flow in the bile in the intestine. It can be white after a barium meal. Visible parasites. Visible parasites like Ascaris or their fragments like tapeworm can be seen sometimes. This should be noted. pH of stool. The normal pH of stool is slightly acidic to slightly alkaline in the range of 5.8 to 7.5. The abnormal pH can be strongly acidic in case of excess of carbohydrates in the diet or fermentation in case of lactose intolerance. It can also be strongly alkaline if there is excess protein intake in the diet. The chemical examination of stools. In chemical examination, we carry out the benzidine test. It is done to detect occult blood in the stool sample. It works on the principle that in an acidic medium, the peroxidase type of hemoglobin in the blood converts hydrogen peroxide to water and nascent oxygen. This nascent oxygen combines with the benzidine powder and forms a green-blue colored complex. Microscopic examination of stool. Microscopic examination is done using either normal saline preparation or iodine preparation, which uses Dugol's iodine solution for staining. The slides prepared are observed under the microscope. In the given figure, we can see the iodine stained preparation on the left and the normal saline preparation on the right. Benefit of the iodine preparation is that iodine stains the cyst, especially the nuclear structure. This was about the stool examination methods in Ayurveda and modern science. Please subscribe the YouTube channel of our college, YMT Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital, for more videos like this. If you like this video, hit the like button and don't forget to share and comment. Thank you.